Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my larger InDesign course on my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. All right, in this video, we're going to create our flyer document. We're going to have the page size, this little red line around the outside, which is bleed, and our margins all set up, ready to go. Let's go and do that. Okay, so create our document. Your welcome screen might look a little different. I've got all these documents that I've previously worked on. So I'm gonna go up to here and go to new. You might be on CC files or something else weird. Okay, I'm gonna click on new. If you can't see that, go up to file, new document. We all end up in the exact same place, which is here. Okay, so what we're gonna do is, you're probably gonna be working in print. Okay, we are in this case, and it gives you some presets. You can see here, view all presets. There's a bunch of stuff we can use. We'll probably never use you, compact disc anymore, but anyway, it's in there. Okay, business card, some useful sizes. In terms of web, okay, and mobile sizes are done in here as well. Okay, so if you're designing InDesign for web, it's not primarily used for that, but hey-ho, you can. So we're gonna use print. In our case, we're gonna use US, we're gonna do like a flyer size, we're gonna do a half letter, okay? If you're following in a country that uses millimeters in the A sizes, this would be an A5, okay? So we use it as half an A4. So we're gonna do half our US letter, okay? And we're gonna make sure, you can see you can override it over here. It still thinks I am in Europe, which I am. You can change it over here. Next thing is the orientation, okay? I wanna put it landscape. Facing pages, we're gonna turn off, okay? And facing pages we'll go into in a lot more detail when we start building our like multiple page brochure further on in this course. But for the moment, if you're just doing like a one page thing, turn off facing pages. Primary text frame as well, it's a little bit complicated and we'll do that in a later video as well, okay? But just make sure they're off for the moment. Number of pages, you can add them later if you want. We're just gonna start with one. Columns, okay? We're only gonna have one column in this case. We'll look at multiple column layout when we get into some more text heavy documents later on. Margins we'll leave as the default, and yours might be a little bit different. So you can see here I can see margins and bleed. Okay, you might just twirl those down if you can't see them. Okay, and I'm gonna go to this bleed one here. So I've done my margins, I left them as the default, bleed. What I'll do is I'll get the real Dan to jump out and show you this because it's better in person. Take it away, Dan. So apparently I am the real Dan, and this real Dan would like to explain bleed and slug. This is my example book. Okay, now what happens when they're printing? We all know that, like say this image at the front here goes right to the edge, okay? The black goes right to the edge. The ad on the back goes right to the edge. Pretty much all of these pages, okay? All these ads here go to the edge of the page. But we know that when we're printing, say at home or at the office, we can never print right to the edge of a white bit of paper, right? Because the printer just doesn't go that close to the edge. That's the same for big commercial offset printers as well. So it doesn't really matter, you can't print right to the edge. So what happens is you print on a little bit of paper that's a little bit bigger. Okay, so say it needs to be letter or A4. What they do is they print it on a sheet called SRA4, which is just a little bit bigger. Okay, and then they print inside of that, and then they guillotine it off afterwards down to the original size. Now that guillotine is never perfect, okay? They try and line it up perfect, but you need a little bit of wiggle room for the guillotine to maybe like slice a little bit higher or a little bit lower. You don't want it right on the edge because they might end up with a little white strip. Okay, so they, what you do in InDesign is you add a little bit of bleed, okay? 3 millimeters for metric, or 1/8 of an inch for imperial, okay? Or 0.125 of an inch if you're using decimal places. And what happens is you just make your document that teeny bit bigger, okay? All the way around so that the guillotine has got something to cut off, okay? And it ends up in the bin. So nothing important there because it'll end up in the bin, okay? But it gets cut down to this final size. Happens especially with magazines. Magazines are printed and bound, and often they don't look this nice. This has got a really sharp, you know, kind of crisp edge, but that never happens when it gets bound. That only happens after it's been guillotined. It's quite messy. If you ever see a magazine that's been printed that doesn't yet, that hasn't been yet been trimmed up, okay, it's actually, the pages are all kind of like messed up and not lined up nicely. It's not until guillotining happens that, and the bleed is cut off before they look nice and tidy. Now, in terms of slug, now the cool thing about slug is you just won't use it, okay? People doing the design side often don't use slug. It's more the printing or production side of things. Let's say that, so the bleed is just like, remember, just a little bit around the outside. The slug is a bigger chunk, like an inch around the outside. And in that, you can write notes, Okay, so if you're the printer and you know that this cover is a bit special and it has something that needs to be glued to it on a special spot, you could write, here's where this gets glued to, or maybe this bit gets stapled to this bit and folded over or something special. Okay, or just anything that maybe helped the production later on after it comes off the printer. It says maybe this gets put with part A and part B. So it's kind of a terrible explanation, but it's just notes that the printer adds. It'll be trimmed off and chucked in the bin. I've never had to put bleed on in my entire career. You probably won't do either, unless you're working maybe behind the scenes in an offset printer or a big commercial printer. You might be adding blood. You might be adding slug afterwards and adding these notes to it. So bleed, definitely. Slug, pretty much never. Did that help? Hope it helped. You can go back to the other Dan, the disembodied voice talking over a screen. Right, so we know we need a bleed, okay, of 0.125 inches, okay, or an eighth of an inch, okay, or if you're a metric, you can just type in 3 millimeters. You can see I can type in 3 millimeters and just click somewhere else and it does the conversion for me. I know it's not exactly the same, but that's just the way it is, okay. Different people use different size bleeds. Okay, and the slug, we don't use you, so we're going to leave that as is. Okay, and let's click create. Stand back, we have a document. Okay, so I'm going to zoom out a little bit. Zooming is command minus on a Mac or control minus on your keyboard, okay, if you're on a PC. And what I want to do is show you the different parts here. So the edge of the big white box is the edge of our page. In our case, it's the US half letter, okay, and we've got these two other colored boxes here. We've got this red one and this magenta one here. Okay, so the magenta is the margins. They don't do anything. They're just a visual guide to keep everything inside and away from the edges of the page, because we all know that our printers don't print right to the edge, so there's like a consistent box around the edge there. Okay, the other one we're going to look at is this red one here, and that is the bleed we discussed. So everything that goes over this edge here prepared to get chopped off and put in the bin. Before we go any further, let's go and save this document. Okay, so let's go up to File and let's go to Save. Where we're going to save it, I'm going to save mine on my desktop. I'm going to make a new folder. Okay, if you're using a Mac and it's a new Mac, you might be looking like this. It looks a little different. Okay, click this little arrow here. Find your desktop on the left-hand side, make a new folder. I'm going to call this one InDesign Class Files. Click create, and we'll stick everything we make during this long course into that folder. In terms of the naming, okay, we're going to call this one Good at Heart, because that's the client. Okay, I'm going to put a hyphen in and we're going to put in flyer, and this is going to be V1. Always give it a version number, okay, because you're going to make changes, people are going to come back. A V1, V2, or ABC is just fine. Okay, never call it final. Final is like the kiss of death. If you call it final, the universe will send you adjustments and you'll have to call it like final 2 or final revisited. There's some people chuckling because you've probably got files just like that all over your computer. Okay, so we're going to use the V system. Let's click save. And that's it for this video, my friends. Let's get on to the next one. So, what did you think? Did you like it? Okay, if you did, please hit the like button and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps my business. Now, this is just a free video from my larger InDesign course. You can see the full version on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site, there is a free cheat sheet you can download. Okay, print it off. Stick it next to your computer, look awesome. The other thing is I have lots of other courses there. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, After Effects, Premiere, Dreamweaver, lots of other ones. So go check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye.